Hello people from the future, welcome to Normalized Nerd. In this video, I'm gonna show you how you can train your own word vectors. If you are new to my channel, then please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon. I make videos about machine learning and data science regularly. I know that some of you are thinking, hey, we already know how to use pre-trained word vectors. Then why on earth we should train our own word vectors? Well, I agree. And I have actually shown you how to use pre-trained word vectors in my previous video. But let me give you some cases where training your custom word vectors will actually be useful. Suppose you want to deploy your NLP model, but the data you are working with is really small. And if you use pre-trained word vectors, then you have to make a storage for the pre-trained model, and generally they are really huge. But if you just train your word vectors on your small dataset, then the size of your word vectors will be low as your vocabulary is low. So in this way, it will be easier for you to deploy the model. In the second case, assume that you are building an NLP model for a language for which no pre-trained word vector exists. In that case, you must build your own word vectors. And in the third case, assume that you are tackling a very specific problem of NLP. Suppose you are working on a dataset which consists of only resume. As you know that the pre-trained word vectors were actually trained on general dataset, so there is a chance that the pre-trained word vector might not work as good in the specific case of the resume. Okay, so these were the three points that I wanted you to keep in the back of your mind, that why are you learning to train your own word vectors. All right, let's jump into the code section. Well, the data I'm using today is the same as in my last video, that is the Happy DB dataset. So I'm not gonna go deeper into the dataset this time. Obviously, I'm gonna post a link to that dataset in the description, so make sure to check that out. I'm just going to give you an overview of it. So this is our text data, and this contains happy moments, and these are the classes. And our task is to make a NLP model such that if we input these text, our model should predict the reason of happiness. Okay, so first of all, I'm doing some basic data cleaning. Before that, see here that we have got 7 classes. Okay, then I'm just counting the number of sentences in each happy moment. Well, this is actually useful because we will get an idea of the distribution of the sentences in our data set. As you can see that there are few happy moments which consist of a large number of sentences, and we really don't need to incorporate them in our training. So we are going to take only those happy moments which have less than or equal to 10 number of sentences. All right, after that we are encoding the class levels. We need to do this because this will help us to convert the class levels into one hot vectors later. This line actually does the encoding. After the encoding, our predicted category column looks something like this. Okay, so now comes the data cleaning for NLP purpose. Now I have a video dedicated to the text preprocessing in NLP. Make sure to check that out to know more about this topic. Here I am using some basic preprocessing techniques. First of all, I am tokenizing my sentences. Then I am removing the punctuations. After that, I am discarding anything that is not an alphabet. And in this step, we are actually converting every capital letters into lower case alphabets. Okay, now I am printing the first 5 happy moments. You can see that the sentences are tokenized and there exist no capital letter, no punctuation, and no numeric character. Okay, moving on. Now I'm just gonna do the train test split. Those of you who have watched my previous video may feel this a little bit monotonous because I have already done it. So for them, please skip a couple of minutes. So basically, I'm here keeping aside 20% of my dataset as validation data, and I am restricting the maximum length of each happy moment to 55. You can experiment with that to see if you can get more accuracy. After that, I'm tokenizing my happy lines. Then I'm calculating the vocabulary size and unique words. After that, I am using a padding here because obviously not every happy moment will be of length 55. Suppose one happy moment is of length less than 55. So I'm just padding a special character to the end of those to make it 55. And if some happy moment has a length greater than 55, then I'm just terminating at the 55th token. Okay. After that, we are randomizing our dataset because in machine learning, randomization is a very important thing to get rid of any particular order in the dataset. After that, we are one hot encoding our class labels. So this line basically says that if class label is 2, then the third element of our vector will be 1 and all the other elements will be 0. Remember that array starts from 0, that's why for class level 2, the third element. After that, we are just splitting our data set into training and validation. And then we are just printing the shapes of the matrices, okay? Now comes the interesting portion where we are actually gonna train our own word vectors. Now to understand this part, I will highly recommend you to actually check my video on word to vec model where I have explained what is skip gram model, what is continuous bag of words model, because without that knowledge, this line won't make much sense. Okay, so I guess you are now comfortable with the skip gram model and continuous bag of words model. So let's continue. So to train our word vectors, that is to train the custom word to vec model, we need to use this function from gensim, gensim.models.word2vec. Now there are a couple of parameters. The first one is sentences. Obviously you need to pass the happy lines. After that, there is a parameter called size. This is just the dimensionality of your word vectors that you want. I am using here 100. Obviously you can change it to 300, 500 to experiment. Now comes the window size that is equal to 5. Well, this is basically tells you how far from the current word you should consider as the context. Again, I am saying that I have explained the concept of context and target word in my previous video, so please check that. After that comes the workers. Well, this is just the number of CPU cores. Then comes the minimum count. This is interesting because suppose you have a larger data set, then it will happen that many words will come multiple times. So to reduce the vocabulary, you can do one thing. You can just increase the minimum count. So the model will take only those words which has this many minimum count. So in my case, I have taken all the words which have appeared at least once in my dataset. So if you just increase this to 2, it will take those words which have appeared at least 2 times. Okay. Now comes the last parameter. Well, obviously there are many parameters, but these many parameters will do the work for you. Okay. So the SG parameter, that is the short form of skip gram parameter. If it is 0, the model will apply continuous bag of words algorithm. If it is 1, then it will apply skip gram algorithm. All right, then you need to save your model. While saving the model, remember that you should make the binary equal to false. Well, you can actually make it true also. In that case, you need to actually read the binary file. Well, that thing also I have mentioned in my previous video. After that, you need to create a dictionary. Then I am reading the text file with Python. You can again do it using gensim, but here I have choose to use native Python. So in this dictionary, the keys are the words and the values are the vector representation of the words. All right. Then we are setting our embedding dimension, that is 100. Then we are initializing our embedding matrix. This embedding matrix will actually help you to create the embedding layer as the first layer of our network. So you can guess that Each row will contain the vector representation of a word. So if the word doesn't exist in your vocabulary, so you just leave the row as zeros. And if it does exist in your vocabulary, you just replace that row with the vector representation of that particular word. After that, we are creating our embedding layer, and using Keras, we can very easily do that. You just need to use this embedding function and you need to pass these arguments. Remember that you are making this trainable parameter false because we have already trained our word vectors here from our dataset. You don't really need to train that here again. As the weights, you need to pass the embedding matrix. Okay, so we are very close to our training part. Here's the last thing. Here we are making our model. As I have told earlier, the first layer will be the embedding layer. Then I'm adding a couple of recurrent neural units. I'm using here long short-term memory, in short LSTM. You can try GRUs also, okay? And here I'm adding a softmax function. Obviously, it is a classification problem and has 7 classes. That's why I have passed here 7 and the activation is softmax. After that, we need to compile this model, and the loss function will be categorical cross entropy. If you are working with binary classification, then this will be binary cross entropy. And the optimizer I am using here is Adam. You may change this. And the matrix that I'll be monitoring here is accuracy metric. Okay, so this is my summary of the model. Before jumping into the training, I am saving some checkpoints because in that way you will get the model after every epoch. And here the save best only. So that means if the validation accuracy doesn't increase, it won't save the model. Okay, so now comes the training. I am doing the training for 15 epochs, and after the 15th epoch, you can see that we have a pretty decent accuracy. So even with our own word vectors, we have got 87% accuracy. So that's something really amazing to me. And if you remember my last video, there we got an accuracy of 88% using pre-trained models. So compared to that, 87% is amazing. Okay, so now I'm just gonna plot the loss versus epoch and accuracy versus epoch graphs. So this is the graph. And one more thing here, I have used continuous bag of words model here. I am highly encouraging you to check what is the result with skip drum model. So that was all for this video. Please like this video, share this video, and subscribe to Normalized Nerd. Thanks for watching.